Now, Palestinians gather in central Gaza to show their appreciation and support for the pro-Palestinian protests happening on university campuses. They held Palestinian flags and signs with the names of universities where the demonstrations are taking place. The rallies have spread to dozens of schools across the U.S. Students in universities in other parts of the world have also begun staging protests to express opposition to Israel's war on Gaza.
Thank you very much indeed for contributing and making our voice audible. Thank you very much indeed for sharing our voice around the world. I recommend you to go more and more, to continue more and more, because I believe in the rights of academics. I believe in the rights of the human beings. Also, I believe that knowledge wins. Knowledge always at the end wins.
We are here to thank you for standing with Gaza during these tough times. Your support shows that caring and kindness can go beyond the border. Your voices are making a real difference. Your support is incredible. Your commitment to the humanitarian values and your dedication to make a real difference in the world are truly inspiring.
Days of mounting tensions boil over at the University of California, Los Angeles. Israel supporters attacked an encampment of pro-Palestinian protesters. Videos of demonstrators setting up makeshift barriers before police were deployed to the campus. The clash at UCLA follows police action to arrest demonstrators occupying a building and remove a protest encampment at Columbia University. The demonstrations in Los Angeles and New York are part of the biggest outpouring of U.S. student activism since the anti-racism rallies and marches of 2020. Meanwhile, students and professors of Columbia University held a press conference to denounce the decision to call in police and lock down the campus. Some 300 people have been arrested and charged with trespassing and criminal mischief. New York's mayor blamed the protests on outside agitators without offering concrete evidence. The university's president has asked police to stay until May 17, 2 days after graduation, with the rest of the semester to be conducted remotely.
That Columbia's administration has decided to circumvent democratic processes, to resort to violent arrests of students, and a militarized lockdown of our campus has irrevocably destroyed any trust between them and the students, staff, and faculty of this community. We strongly and emphatically declare no confidence in this administration. Most immediately, we call on them to reopen campus and dismiss the police immediately. Last night, we experienced extreme police brutality while defending Hinds Hall. Despite our peaceful protest, the police ambushed us. We were tackled and beaten. My hands were handcuffed so tightly that even lifting my pinky caused extreme harm and excruciating pain. Nonetheless, our determination for the liberation of Palestine remains unshaken.
U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken calls for the further acceleration of aid delivery into Gaza during a visit to Israel. Blinken says while real progress has been made on improving humanitarian access, more needs to be done given the immense need in the Palestinian enclave. But he also stresses the decision for a Gaza ceasefire is now in the hands of Hamas.
Israel has made very important compromises in the proposal that's on the table, demonstrating its desire and willingness to get this agreement and get it done. Now, as we've been saying, it's on Hamas. Hamas has to decide whether it will take this deal and actually advance the situation for the people that it purports to care about in Gaza. There is no time for delay. There's no time for further haggling. The deal is there. They should take it.
Blinken also made a brief stop in southern Israel, where Hamas militants launched their attack on October 7, killing 1,200 people and abducting 253 others. Israel's retaliatory attack, meanwhile, has now killed more than 34,000 Palestinians and turned large parts of the enclave into a wasteland. Disgraced Hollywood mogul Harvey Weinstein will be retried in New York a week after the state's highest court overturned his 2020 rape conviction. The new trial is expected after the Labor Day holiday in the U.S., which falls on September 2. Weinstein was present during Wednesday's hearing. He is serving a 23-year prison sentence in upstate New York.
We will now digest every syllable of the prior testimony of all the witnesses. We will assemble a team of the best and the brightest and make sure that this case is litigated properly in front of an excellent judge who the difference between this judge and the last judge is night and day. And we're very confident that if it goes to trial, the only words we'll hear at the end of the trial are not guilty.
In February 2020, Weinstein was convicted of sexually assaulting former production assistant Miriam Haley in 2006 and of raping aspiring actress Jessica Mann in 2013. They are among the 80 women who have accused him of sexual misconduct. Weinstein was also sentenced to 16 years in a separate rape trial in California. The two sentences cannot be served concurrently. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news making headlines for Filipinos in North America.
We begin with a new Quinnipiac University poll released last week, wherein a record number of Americans, 66%, now support legal abortion, the highest level of support ever recorded by the poll in its two-decade history.
Abortion is health care. We want it now.
Despite the growing support for legal abortion in the country, a new, more restrictive abortion law takes effect in Florida on May 1st.
Show the bill passes.
The state joins most states in the Southeast, banning most abortions after 6 weeks of pregnancy, and the state that is now poised to take the influx of patients from those Southeastern states is North Carolina. It allows access of up to 12 weeks of pregnancy.
This is not a decision that we should make for other people. It's their individual decision, their medical, their life decision.
Maria Cervania, the first Filipino-American elected official to North Carolina legislature, tells ABS-CBN News she is prepared to tackle any potential political fight ahead to protect a woman's right to choose what's best for her health. Meanwhile, excitement is building up for the Philippine Department of Tourism's 2024 Very Important Pinoy or VIP Tour, scheduled from July 21st to 30th in the Philippines. This year's VIP Tour has a greater focus on cultural exploration from Luzon, Visayas to Mindanao. The first leg of the VIP Tour is Metro Manila.
Some of the highlights of the Manila leg are the wreath laying ceremony at Rizal Park, where usually the participants would wear their Filipiniana outfits. In the afternoon, participants get to choose the activities they want to do. They can join the Charms of Old Manila, where they will visit Fort Santiago, San Agustin Church, and Museum. Some can enjoy the Chinatown walking tour and visit the Binondo Church Market and try some local food. Or they can also choose the shopping tour and buy souvenirs and pasalubongs for their loved ones.
For more information on the 2024 VIP Tour, you may visit VIPTourPhilippines2023.com. And finally, the rain did not dampen the spirits of festival goers who walked the six blocks from East 43rd to East 48th Avenue to experience the first Lapu-Lapu Day block party in Vancouver. Various booths line the block, serving food, offering goods and services, and fun and games. Thousands came to the block party, which honors the chieftain of Bactan, in the Philippines' 1521 victory against the then colonizers from Spain.
To have a new event spearheaded by a new generation of Filipinos and really embracing our culture now more than ever is just such a fulfilling feeling to be a part of and to help spearhead that.
And those are the newsmaking headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.